With me, I have Chhavi, who is a software engineer at Google, and she gave a talk on Google Assistant. Hi, Chhavi.
Hi.
Chhavi, can you tell us a little bit more about your talk?
Taking a step back, if you see the evolution of technology, when phones first came in, we had to press like so many buttons to get anything done. Then we moved on to the era of touch screens, like you could just press some buttons and like gestures and everything, trying to interact with the help of touch. Mm-hmm. Now we are moving to the era of voice. And one of the great things about Assistant is like, it's everywhere. It's in your mobile, it's in your watches, it's in your, slowly it gets in your cars and your speakers and everything. And so anything that you build for the Assistant will be available instantaneously on all of these platforms. The talk was about how students can develop for Google Assistant. Assistant has been thought of as a product that people can use to interact with and get things done. But now we want people to think of it as a platform where students can go and work on their own ideas and get that idea to more people. So let's just say like for people like my parents and even generation before them, trying to press buttons, trying to go to websites is kind of a very difficult process. But just being able to tell what you want and for the device to figure it out on its own and get you the results would be the step forward.
Okay, Google, let me talk to Personal Chef.
Sure, here's Personal Chef.
And like Assistant is working on getting indigenous languages, even languages like Hindi, Marathi and Bengali into its platform. And so you can like connect with anyone, anywhere. It'll be so easy to do anything.
I've been using this for my own purpose also. And it's just like I'm talking to an actual human being.
Yes, so the Assistant is broken down in like three parts. One is machine learning, one is speech recognition. And the third part, the most important, would be language understanding. So being able to convert what you say into text, I think would be the easier part. But being able to understand what that text means, like what the user wants. So Google has been working on it for like years and it still has a very large team working in those efforts and improving it every day. 3 years ago, if you wanted to translate one thing into another language, you might not have seen such great results. But over the years, we've seen it perform phenomenally, and that's the same kind of results we're expecting from the Assistant, that it's able to learn on the users and it's able to perform per the expectations of the users.
One last question. So how do you think Google Assistant is going to help our DSC lead students out there?
The intention of the talk was to introduce students that stop thinking of Assistant as a technology that Google has built for you. Start thinking of it as a platform that you can build for. We had some great ideas right there in the talk. Like one student was talking about if floods and anything, like in cities like Mumbai, you face constant floods and everything. So, and people in Mumbai have the data of what are the safe places. And so if they build an application, which if you talk to the Assistant and it's able to tell you what are the safe places to rush to right there. So students can build something like that for the Assistant. So a platform that Google has built for the world can also target small areas and small situations with the help of these students. Because the aim of DSC students is to tackle local problems and local businesses. And Assistant would be a great platform for that.
It was really nice talking to you, Chhavi. Thank you.